protecting my peace has become my priority. This is my Second Amendment right. According to our Constitution, yeah, I have the right to bear arms, which better means I have the right to shed your emotional baggage we tend to carry on our sleeves, and have the right of my arms to be free from carrying your expectations of how I should think. No, I think I'ma choose me this time, and I'ma protect my peace. How often do we get roped in foolish conversations? The bull that they're riding is unleashed as they see red on their reply, but no response. Because this rodeo is full of clowns putting themselves in harm's way, and I'm not gonna go back and forth like an Aaliyah record. Social media can be the worst sometimes. Keyboard warriors with opinions more shallow than a puddle of dog piss on the pavement. I refuse to click, comment, and create my space in my mind for an internet debate that only causes that cacophony of chaos and confusion. I'm protecting my peace. It's a concealed carry, but my peace stays strapped to me. Locked and loaded, the caliber of my convictions carries enough bang to blow a big enough hole in your expectations. So when you piss me off, instead of giving you a piece of my mind, I hope to leave you with the peace of my mind. A peace that passes understanding. A peace only the Holy Spirit can provide. A peace that stills the welter waters of your turmoil. A peace that helps you stand where others fall. That peace is worth protecting. I don't care who comes knocking to strip away from me my lawfully purchased firearm, because the heat attached to my shoulders carries the weight of responsibility executing the protection of the home of my mind, knowing I cannot have God's peace without God's priorities. Can I get a yes and amen? This amen meant we have an agreement. My peace is my priority. It's wholesome. It's holy. Never leave home without it. Nah, I keep that thing on.